rich, wealthy bachelor, 30 and on. And now a new crotchet crept into his pate. A wife must he have, whatsoever betide, and well lined with rubbish to enrich his estate. Fair maidens were offered him 2, 3, and 4, sufficient men's daughters with money to boot. Yet his greedy mind did still gape after more, for he said was too little for him to go to it. Shall I, for a paltry £4,000, a young wench go marry with nothing but breed, consume me in longings and fashions and toys? Nor yet is it time, and now will I take heed. There is a brisk widow that dwelleth hard by, did money £10,000 have in the least, I'll spruce myself up then incontinently, and to her I'll go as a suitoring guest. This bachelor soon did attain his desire, the day was appointed when they should be wed. His youthful fair bride was but 80, for she had but a 2½ in her head. Some 3 or 4 years did this bonny lass live, then grim good man death took her life clean away, and grief for her loss had the man almost sped, but that a new widow his journey did stay. Wife being buried, next morning he went, another spruce widow again for to see, where mounted on crutches he straight one espied, who in state of riches was better than she. His mother's smock sure did this widow aware, for no sooner wooed but he presently sped, a license he filched, and he married her straight, then she threw down her stilts and hobbled to bed. Not full 10 years older than was his last wife, was this same dry mummy that lay by his side, with snorting and grunting she so ate the bed, that never had groomed such a knife by a bride, but still did her money all perfume again. And in a month after all bedrid did lie, 7 winters and summers she lay at small ease, and then she departed because she must die. 500 a year she augmented estate, £10,000 clear by the other he got. Meantime of another spruce widow he heard, then he prayed unto Jove that she might be his lot. Above 50 at most, so spruce and so neat was her carcass bedressed. She wanted no means for to set her to sail. They liked and were married, now mark well the rest. She seemed so complete and so comely of shape, he doted on her more than both of the rest. She said, then, sweet husband, be not you dismayed, for the truth must be known when you see me undressed. 2 rows of white teeth she took out of her mouth, and put them straight into a little brown box. A glass eye likewise she pulled out of her head, which made the man fear his wife had got pox. Her powdered curled locks that so fair did appear, came off with more ease than a new scolding pig. I wonder her husband could laughing forbear, when he saw his wife look like an ostrich's egg. Then straightway down stooped this comely sweet bride, unlaced and ungirded her neat wooden leg. The bridegroom was like to run out of his wits, for his eyes there before did behold such a hag. Then for to revive him, unto him she flung her keys that did lead to treasure great store. This made him to love her, so both went to bed, where he did embrace her, what would you have more? But ere 1 month's change she ended her life, a rich wealthy miser invited him home, and said, if you please, sir, I'll show you a wife. He showed him a daughter, a girl of 15, but she would no ling nor favour him show. Her friends made the match and they married with speed, but she ne'er endured him, I tell you but so. This young married wife to such cunning was grown, that she fell a-longing his coin for to waste. French kickshaws of £10 a dish would she have, with other dear meats for to fit her fine tastes. No physic, no doctor, no cost did she spare, on pride and newfangled she set her delight. Her husband began for to save her of fear, and to wish that she ne'er had been seen in his sight. Nor love, nor like, this young wife e'er had, because she was forced to be wed to her hate. He sickened and died, and was laid in his grave, so she did enjoy his 3 widows' estate. A young man that first was the widow's true love. With all expedition they made their dispatch. For wedding and bedding they both were agreed, and the three widows' husband did meet with his match.